This original WSRE presentation is made possible by viewers like you. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Dee Dee Sharp, and welcome to this holiday edition of The Aware Show. We're glad to have you right there. 'Tis the season to be jolly, and on today's program, we're celebrating with special music performances and sweet gourmet treats. But before we get to that, we want to put you in the spirit of peace on earth and goodwill to all men. This season is a time for caring, giving, and gratitude. Our community is very fortunate to have so many wonderful charitable and religious organizations that provide community outreach to families in need. These organizations are your brother's keepers, not just during the holiday season, but each and every day. And so here on This Aware Show, we want to spotlight the amazing Epps Christian Center here in Pensacola. That's where you'll find Reverend Sylvia Tisdale there cooking to provide hot meals for those in need. And she welcomes volunteers like Leadership Pensacola to come and help serve the food up. It's a win-win situation for those who receive and for those who give goodwill.
You all came out here today. Tell us why you came out.
Because we're freezing and we needed some warm clothes and blankets and we're hungry, so when we came for the hot food, it's nice, but the canned goods are good too. So,
what does it mean to have something like Epps Christian Center in the community?
This place is great because a lot of the places, I'm told, we've only been here about a year, and we've spent a little time homeless on the streets and a little time living wherever we can, but you can come here without, like, I hear a lot of the other food pantries you have to get references to and stuff. She doesn't do all that. She don't ask many questions. She just gives you what you need, so it's a good thing. We'd have been real hungry without this today.
What about you?
It's just a great place. That's all I can say. Everybody should come out who needs help.
Yeah.
How does it feel to know that someone's just so giving of a heart, especially this time of the year, but every day, really,
yeah,
she helps?
She really is. I've dealt with Pastor Tisdale other times, and when she, this summer, I helped out a little with her food drives and stuff, but she does have a good heart, and she's just so grateful for the community involvement. She loves it. She just, that really does her heart good, so then she passes it on to everybody else, makes everyone else feel, but she never makes you feel crappy because you're homeless or dirty or, yeah, she's good. She's normal person.
So you love so much what she does in the community that you actually volunteer here yourself.
Sometimes.
So you've been a recipient and a volunteer.
Yeah, sometimes. I used to in the summer. Now I live farther away and it's a longer walk, so I don't get over here as much as I'd like. But yeah, she's great like that, you know. She don't discriminate. She's good.
And for you, sir, to have something like this where you can come and get a warm meal, even gifts for the holiday, what does that mean to you?
I feel as though that I'm really blessed. I'm really, really blessed. And I bless everybody and wish everybody a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Tell us about your organization and why you all are here.
Leadership Pensacola is a program that annually gets the future leaders of Pensacola together. And today our topic is quality of life. And we want to show these future leaders and leaders of what exactly is in Pensacola. Because a lot of times we're siloed in our own world and think that all of Pensacola is exactly that way. So we wanted them to give them an opportunity really to feel other things, experience other things, and be mindful and start the conversation that we need to build a stronger community by knitting together a quilt of all our different strengths and talents.
This is an opportunity for them to see that and volunteer. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yes, they will be able to learn more about this organization and others throughout the day, and they can offer their time, talent, and treasure as they are so called to do. It's a very personal choice, but if they didn't know about this, they would have never known to help. So.
And where do you hope this experience will take some of the people who are coming up through your program?
Well, we know that as future leaders and leaders in Pensacola, that it will make our community stronger, because educating them about the real situation in the community will empower them to make right decisions and take right-minded actions.
We wish you the best of success. Happy New Year and Merry Christmas to you and yours.
Thank you very much. Same to you, and we appreciate you helping us spread the word.
Jeff, just want to get an opportunity to have you tell us why you decided to do this and what your involvement is with Lee.
Really wanted to give back to Pensacola. Pensacola's been great to me. I grew up here, fourth generation here. Just want to be able to give back. So far, we've just been learning a lot of things we didn't know about the community, getting to see things we don't see all the time. And I've learned a lot so far. I'm looking forward to giving back.
And what about you, John?
A lot of the same reasons. You know, Pensacola has a lot to offer everyone. And this gives us a chance to learn a little bit more about it, especially on days like this where we can actually physically give back something too, besides just learning about something.
There are a lot of people in need here in Pensacola, and you guys are on the front lines today. What's going to be your takeaway from this after having volunteered and worked with them and met some of these people face to face?
A lot of it's just seeing things that I don't see all the time. So going forward, just kind of opening my eyes a little bit more and looking for things that aren't always on the beaten path.
What about you?
I think it just makes you appreciate a whole lot more about what you have and what friends and family and everyone else has around you.
What do you guys think this experience will do for you and what you do with Leadership Pensacola going forward?
I think it's all just kind of part of it. It's it just all kind of comes together week by week, or month by month, rather. The more we participate, the more we get from it.
And what about you, John? What do you think all this will be in a takeaway for you?
Yeah, I think part of what we're doing in Leadership Pensacola and our project is to try to do something and give a little bit back to the community. And so I think all of these little exercises actually help us make our project even better.
Well, we wish you the best. Thank you for what you're doing here today. Have a Merry Christmas, and hopefully some of these folks will too now.
All right. Thanks.
Thank you.
All right, as you can see, the center is doing some extraordinary things, and it's not just during the holiday, as we mentioned before, but it's every day. And joining us in the studio is the phenomenal woman behind this charitable gift giving of the heart, Reverend Sylvia Tisdale, who's joining us here. Thank you so much. She is the founder of the Epps Christian Center, and of course, we appreciate you for allowing our AWARE cameras to come on location actually get that footage. It was lovely to be there, and
it was so
heartwarming to see everybody in action, the volunteers, the people who are receiving it, and even the people who are receiving all this love who have actually also volunteered to give it as well. Great job in the community. Wanted to put the spotlight on you.
Well, thank you.
How did all this get started, Reverend Tisdale, for you?
Well, I kept my mother, Marie Epps, for 10 years, and she was an invalid. But she always went to the Oaks daycare, and she used to call it her school. And after she passed away, I wanted to build a senior citizen, a place for a senior citizen to go. Well, the property that I had bought, they told me that it wasn't zoned for that, but the only thing it was zoned for was a church or a group home. So I said, well, what I can do is I can have my senior care coming out of the church. So with the property, I started Epps Christian Center in order to have my senior functions coming out of the building. And so after that, the Lord blessed me to move from the place that I originally had to Pace Boulevard, the building that I have my soup kitchen at. And then after about a year and a half, the Lord said he was going to bless me with another building. So I didn't know if you noticed it or not, but across the street is my church building where we meet Wednesday night and Sunday mornings and Sunday evenings. So then I asked God, I said, well, what am I going to do with this building now? And because I was trying to figure out how I could get some money to pay for the other building, because the ministry was small and still is small. And the Lord said, I want you to feed the needy. And of course, I'm from South Carolina and 12 in my family. But then I told the Lord, I said, wait a minute, what you talking about, Lord? I said, that's not going to bring any money in. Mm-hmm. And he said, this is what I want you to do. And, you know, of course, God talked to you like just like that. And that morning I said, okay. So I woke up early one morning and I went down to what I call my soup kitchen building now. And I cooked a big, big pot of grits, and I cooked some bacon and cooked some sausage. And at that time, the pace setter was right across the street. So I went across the street, and I said, all these guys were around waiting to go to do day labor. And I fixed a big pot of coffee, and I said, hey, guys, how would you all like to have a breakfast? And they looked at me saying, how much it costs, you know, in the expression. And I said, it's free. And they said, free? I said, yes, it's free. So that first morning was in April of 2006. They came across the street, and I served 23 people that first morning. And from there,
awesome.
And from there, it was such a great feeling to, you know, to feed that morning. I just continued to do it.
And that morning, go ahead.
Yeah, and I was just doing it as. I knew they had to go out to work, and I said this would give them a hot meal on their stomach, you know, to help them do a good day's work. Mm-hmm. And so it benefited me just by seeing their face, and you know, knowing that I was doing something to help them do a day's work.
Okay. And that day was 10 years later. That's what I was going to put in there, because you've been doing this a very long time.
Yeah, 10 years later.
And you still serve the breakfast as
well.
And
I still serve the breakfast. And at that time, the reason I did it and is doing it early, a lot of people don't want to volunteer because it's so early, but I was doing it early to help them get out to work. And then I was substitute teaching school at that time. So that helped me to feed them early and to be to work by 8 o'clock.
Now that's obedience. Well, now you do the soup kitchen with the breakfast in the morning, and you also assist with the food pantry.
Yes.
Because a lot of people are able to come over and get food as well.
Yes,
non-perishable.
We have our food pantry on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 6 a.m. to 12. We do everything in the morning because I was brought up on the farm. And we go to the food bank once a month. And we really get over 13,000 pounds of food. And that's how much we really give out monthly. And we take in about over 200 people, 200 families come through our ministry every week. And just like the LEAP program saw, somebody asked me, why do you do what you do? And the only thing I can tell them, you just have to come and see the people, see the expression, see that you're really doing something to help somebody else. And someone told me, you really don't start living until you are actually helping somebody else and thinking about somebody else other than yourself.
Awesome, awesome. And even you would think that with charitable giving and you having your non-denominational church that, you know, people would just so willingly be helpful and or people willingly receive the help. But you actually face some challenges doing what you do in the area that you do it in. Tell us more about that.
Well, yes, I face, you know, the financial challenges in that I am retired and because, you know, God gave me the vision, I knew that I had to make it happen. And so I don't mind making a sacrifice because, you know, that's what I was called to do this ministry.
Well, what about in this particular area?
Yeah, in the particular area we have, it's a underprivileged area. It's drug infested. And poverty level is the lowest in Escambia County. And I think we bring a real hope in that when people come we have that smiling face in the morning. And as the lady said, they feel that they can get a bite to eat, they can get a hot meal, they can get some hot coffee without restraints. I don't go into details about what you have, this and that, because everybody basically live below the poverty level, and especially in that area.
And that's the one thing that we heard resoundingly, my photographer and I, Mike Rowan, appreciate him as well, going out on a cold day to do this. But I just want to say we could see that so many people, who some of which didn't want to talk off on camera, were all saying the same thing, mm-hmm. that they didn't feel judged. Mm-hmm. They felt safe and right. okay to come and get a hand of help.
Right. Well, you know, I tell everybody, when I was coming up, family 12, we were poor and didn't know it. And of course, it rained more on the inside than the outside. And I'm one that always remember where I came from. That's why I can look at others, you know, I can look at others and say, you know, I was there one time and I just want to be a help. But this community really has supported me. I have people that private donation they give to me. And last year, it wasn't on my website, but last year, someone broke into my soup kitchen around Thanksgiving time. And they took all my turkeys and just my computers and everything. And the entire Pensacola community, they gathered around me, and I got double for my trouble. I really did.
Awesome.
It was such a blessing. It really encouraged my heart to go on. And I don't get everything that I need, but I get enough, and people encourage me enough to continue to do what we're doing. So it's been a blessing to me, you know, just to do
so
what we do.
You might not get everything you want, but
that's
you get all you need.
All you need, and that's all that matters, you know.
Yes.
Every month, we pay the mortgage, we pay the light bill, we provide the food, you know, by once a month, going to the food bank, we rent a U-Haul. We get the gas, we go there, and the Lord sent volunteers to help us lift the 13,000 pounds of food to and from. So, and the people, like I said, it's just a blessing seeing
awesome.
And seeing the people that come in. And
good job, Pensacola. Good job.
Like I said, yeah. I have so many that it just that I don't want to start naming, but so many people. Saw something in me, you know, to even support what we do.
Awesome. Let me ask you this. Where will we see Reverend Sylvia Tisdale and the Epps Christian Center in the future? Because I know you've got some great plans on that you're going to get off the table and out in the community.
Well, we recently had a five-year school through the 21st Century Grant. And of course, that ended in July. But we do senior citizens of my heart, as well as the needy and the homeless. And I see a resource center in that area that the homeless and the needy, they can come and apply for jobs. They can come and, you know, definitely get interviewing skills that they need, and they can get maybe help counseling and stuff. To help them along the way. I also see us expanding because, of course, you see the little building, and most times when people come in out the cold, we don't have the facility for them to really sit and just warm up a little bit. We do carry out plates. If they want to sit and stay, they can, but most times we provide carry out plates and for them to take the breakfast and the coffee and stuff like that. So I would love to expand the building that people would have a little space that they can sit and just, you know, have a little breakfast out of the cold. And having this Christmas celebration, I was glad to have it, and I was glad to leap chose to come our way because many of the people, when it came, they didn't have gloves, they didn't have hats, and it's getting cold now. And it touched my heart that my people that come in didn't have gloves, hat, or blankets and stuff. And as I approached, they approached me, I said, yeah, it'd be a good opportunity for us to buy some gift bags. They needed socks, they needed gloves, they needed hats, they needed toiletry. And I think we were able to provide the need of a few of those.
Well, we wish you the best.
Thank you.
All right, and I thank you for being here, Reverend Tisdale.
Thank you.
For all that you do in our community, we appreciate
you. Thank you.
That's why we wanted to put the spotlight on you.
Well, thank you for having me.
Absolutely. All right, well, if you want to know more about the Epps Christian Center and what you can do to actually help Reverend Tisdale, she invites you to just check her out, and you can do that by the information we have here on the screen, including her website. Just jot down the information on the Epps Christian Center, a gift of love from the heart to the community. And today, Aware was proud to put a spotlight on Reverend Tisdale. All right, so that's a little something to warm your heart and get you in the holiday spirit. But now we want to bring you in the kitchen to smell and taste with Chef Kamathi Robinson is cooking. All right, well, if you regularly watch the Aware Show, then you know I love to eat. But what we don't get a chance to do very often is a cooking segment. So what better way to celebrate the holidays than to actually look at some quick and easy holiday treats that you can prepare as you entertain your guests. In the Aware Kitchen again, we have Chef Kamathi, and I'm thanking you so much for being here on the Aware Show. It's really exciting for me because, as I mentioned, I love to eat. What are we going to be making today?
All right, so today we're going to be making a spiced holiday punch and pecan cinnamon rolls with orange and citrus icing.
All right, I already love you. Let's get to it.
Okay, so let's start with the punch. It's based in cranberry juice, brown sugar, spices, ginger, allspice, cinnamon, the typical winter holiday flavors. This is a great punch served chilled or warm, but we're gonna do chilled for today.
I like it a lot. Cranberry juice is so good for you too.
Yes, excellent. Mm-hmm. Great antioxidants, vitamin C. So.
And this is a fun way because some people, you know, for cranberry juice, it's kind of bitter, but I think what you're gonna do is gonna be very sweet.
Yes.
Can't wait.
So for this recipe, we're using 2 cups of brown sugar, 1 cup of lemon juice, 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of ginger, and 8 whole garlic cloves. But we've gone ahead and ground cloves, the spice cloves.
First time on Aware, jitters.
Yeah.
All right.
So we're just gonna incorporate this in.
All right. Okay. And so now you can do it all. I understand that you wanted to do this because it's one of those dishes that's good for breakfast, it's good for lunch or brunch, and it's also a good dessert.
Absolutely.
Anytime type food.
Cinnamon rolls are a favorite in my family, and I'm sure many, many others. Mm-hmm. Something we like to do on Christmas morning because something we have time to do. On that particular day, we are usually pressed for time, and it's a great way to satisfy that sweet tooth that everybody has.
All right.
So we just mix that in, incorporate it, and make sure all the sugar and the spices are dissolved. And we're going to, looks like we've got a little settled at the bottom. We keep mixing.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
So we're going to garnish that with a fresh orange and lemon wedge.
Okay. How about that? So now what got you into cooking? This has got to be an interesting story because you're a son of Pensacola?
Yes.
And so you decided that you wanted to be a chef. How did we come to that?
Well, I've always had a passion for cooking ever since I was a little kid, as long as I can remember, honestly. Mm-hmm. It's kind of something that's just run in my family. My grandfather had a restaurant. My grandmother ran industrial commercial kitchens for many years, and it's just something that I gravitated to naturally.
Okay.
All right.
Well, we're going to get started now with those. Oh, no, that looks delicious.
Shall we try it before we
I'll do it.
Go further on?
Sure.
Cheers.
Mm.
You can really taste that.
You know
cinnamon.
What? That's when you don't have to fake it to make it. That's really, really good.
Exactly.
I'm telling you.
Okay.
I'm keep sipping on mine while you're going on.
All right. So for the pecan cinnamon rolls, we're going to start with a little bit of apple juice. That's going to help the yeast activate the sugar
apple
in there.
Apple juice. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Most bread recipes usually call for a little bit of sugar, but
okay.
The apple juice has a natural sugar and it has a great distinct flavor of its own. So that's why I like to start with that. And water, of course, yeast, and we're gonna, you know, typical bread method. You put those together and let them activate. We've also got 3.5 cups of flour here.
And we'll show you that that recipe in just a moment on the screen.
Right.
Okay.
So we've already done the dough.
Okay.
And we're gonna start over here on our rolling board.
Okay.
I'm going to take a little bit of flour.
I'm going to take my drink. And so, what was the name of the drink?
The drink is a spiced holiday punch.
Spiced holiday punch.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. So we're going to turn this dough out onto a floured surface.
All right, now I actually love cooking, but I don't like cleaning up the mess, and I notice you're very meticulous.
Yes. And clean
so,
as you go.
Yes.
So do you
yes.
learn a lot about as a chef?
So, tell us what's going on here.
Okay, so what I'm doing, the dough has doubled in size.
Okay.
Because the yeast is, the dough is fermented.
Right.
And it's nice and airy and soft. So we're rolling it out. You want it to be about 1/4 inch. You can go a little bit thicker if you like thicker, heavier rolls.
I love the
rolls.
Doughy taste for stuff.
Okay.
That's just me.
So you might want to go a little bit thicker, maybe
yeah.
3/8 right. to 1/2 inch thick. That nice and evenly rolled out.
All right, you got about 3 minutes left.
Okay. So you take this, and then we're going to do our filling.
Okay.
Coming right back, sorry.
No problem.
All
I'm
right.
I'm enjoying this.
So I have a stick of softened butter here mm-hmm. and brown sugar and cinnamon in this bowl.
And when it says soft butter, you really need to do that because that's key to some ingredients.
Most definitely.
Yes.
You're going to have real problems mixing the mixing,
mixing the mixture.
Mixing hard butter, yeah.
Oops. Okay.
So.
Put that together?
Yes.
All right.
Oops. And a bigger bowl
mm-hmm.
is never gonna hurt you.
Okay.
So, for the purposes of time.
Okay. You get that together.
Yep.
And you put it on top there.
Exactly.
Okay.
You're gonna spread that out.
Okay. Gotcha.
Over the dough.
Okay.
Excuse me. Over your dough.
Gotcha.
And, oops, you're going to roll. Roll your dough,
mm-hmm.
and you're going to slice and pan into a pre-greased pan.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're all set and done, they're going to need to rise for another hour.
Gotcha.
But when they're all done.
This is my favorite part, when it's all done.
you're going to have your cinnamon rolls.
Nice.
All right. So we've got the recipe on the Aware site, which mm-hmm. we can share with all the viewers at home.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a real crowd pleaser.
Okay, and I understand that you also do catering and that sort of thing as well?
Yes, catering, personal chef service, all the above.
So where will we see Chef Kamathi in just a few years from now?
Possibly at a party near you.
I love that so much, and I understand that you have a new family member you want to tell us about?
Yes, my wife and I have just welcomed our son last week, as a matter of fact. So we're very excited about that.
And so he'll be cooking in the kitchen with you soon, too?
Most likely.
All right. Well, we certainly thank you for joining us here. I'm going to enjoy my spice punch here with the cranberry juice. I love this. This is absolutely wonderful.
Thank you.
All right. As always, thank you for being here, and we hope to have you again in the future.
All right.
All right. Well, the pecan cinnamon rolls are going to be delicious. I'm going to take a bite in just a moment. But for right now, we just want to let you know that the information available for Chef Kamathi Robinson is on our screen right now. We want to show that information to you just in case you want to get in contact with him and find out more information about what he does in the kitchen. For right now, thank you again for being here. And we're going to have some entertainment for you just a moment. I absolutely love this most wonderful time of the year, and I hope you do too. Well, today we've highlighted the Epps Christian Center, and we let you know how you can get involved in their community outreach program. And we've also featured gourmet chef Kamathi Robinson with some quick and easy ideas for your holiday treats. Now for your entertainment, and there's no better way to help you get in the mood for the holidays than to listen to Christmas carols and holiday themed music. I'm sure you'll agree. So joining me in the studio now are two very talented local vocalists, Miss Kijane Chester, who's a senior at Booker T. Washington High School, and Dwayne Crocker, who is currently a student at Pensacola State College. He's also the BET 2015 Race to the Stage winner during the Sunday Best finale show. Congratulations to you, and welcome to you both for being here on The Aware Show. We're glad to have you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
I'm glad to be here.
Yeah, thank you. And so now I'm going to start with you, Kijane, because the most interesting thing about you is the voice that you have, which we're going to hear in just a moment, is not that of like unlike anything that I've heard for someone in your age group. So when did you start singing?
As far as I know, I started when I was 2 years old, and ever since then I grew up in the church. So I started in the church choir, and my mom just pushed me to, you know, just sing with my brother. He played the piano, just church to church. We just sung over and over, and that what inspired me to like do what I do now.
Absolutely amazing. What about you, Dwayne? What got you started? And how did you know that you had this amazing voice and that you could go on to do great things like what you're doing already?
Well, I started around the age of 5 years old. It was really my parents who are pastors who had a church. And I was a musician at the church. And my mom taught me how to play the keyboard. And next thing you know, I was playing and singing and, you know, That's where it started.
That's amazing.
Yes, ma'am.
And so we have you, Kijane. You are a senior at Booker T. Washington High School with aspirations of going to Pensacola State. And that's so good for us. We're glad to have you coming. And of course, with you, Dwayne, you're already here. Tell us a little bit about your experience in your journey here at Pensacola State and what you're doing and your journey all the way to BET's Sunday Best 2015.
Well, I start off by talking about the BET experience. That was an amazing experience. The question that I get all the time is, Kirk Franklin really that short? Yes, he is. So if anybody is wondering, yes, he is. It was an amazing experience to be able to sit on that platform with such amazing artists such as Kiara Shear, Yolanda Adams, Donnie McKirkland, and many more greats that were there. And I was blessed to be able to have the opportunity to stand up there. And my experience here at Pensacola State College has been even much greater than the Sunday Best experience, with the teachers and the students, being able to interact with the students and, you know, just be able to help. You know, I find myself helping other singers here at Pensacola State College, students that want to, you know, be aspiring artists, you know. Mm-hmm. So it's been an amazing journey here as well.
Yeah, I think it's just beautiful the how you put that too, because you actually flipped that thing around and you said your journey to become the BET Sunday Best is nothing like even being here. We didn't prompt you to say that either.
Oh, no,
that's how
no,
you
no.
really feel.
Yes, ma'am.
And Kijane, okay, I'm going to get your name right in a second. I've been saying it the whole time and now I don't want to say it. But Kijane, tell us a little bit about what your aspirations are.
Well, I really do want to major in music when I do come here to attend PSC, and I just want to be a voice to the younger generation. I just want to like just be there for them, like give them a voice. And that's why me and my brother, we have a studio and we make music. We try to make our original music, and we just go on and go on trying to make a good a good voice to it, like a good vibe to it, not all about, you know, the streets, drugs and everything. We try to, you know, be positive about what we do. And so when I'm making music, I want to make it to be positive. I just want it to be positive, everything I have to it.
That's wonderful because, as we all know, music is universal. It's a universal language, so Absolutely. It speaks to so many people in so many different ways. And, you know, you can tell talented people because when they're doing something they love to do, they describe it the way you just described.
Yes, ma'am.
The way you're doing music and singing and that sort of thing. We're excited to have you guys here on The Aware Show. But for someone who's aspiring to be a singer and that sort of thing, what would you say, Dwayne?
I'd say stay focused because that's the main struggle for young people, of course, is staying focused. Our focus get drawn off by, you know, sometimes we see other people. It may seem like another route is easier because one of our friends may have taken another route or whatnot. But if it's really what you want to do, you know, if singing is really what you want to do, just stay focused on singing, you know, learn everything about it, you know, learn your chords, you know, with music and your music notes, learn the scale and all of that so you can know when it's time, you can know what you need to know, mm-hmm. basically.
So. Now, I'm just going to tell you the truth. I mentioned this before we got started. I would say I can't sing. You know, I sing in the key of none, you know, no key. But I noticed you guys, when you were warming up, you were discussing that for someone who has no clue. How do you guys go about getting on? These guys are going to do a duo, and they've never sang together, and they're going to do it here on their Aware Show in just a few minutes. But how does all that go? I know some of it's warming up and all that other good stuff, but for people who don't know, how do you guys do what you do?
You go first.
Well, first you have to, I would like to be in front of a piano when I'm warming up. So how do you really explain it to them is just, well, how I explain it to anyone else. You start at one key and then you pick a key, which one ever you want that sounds great together. So if I'm at ha, you have ha, ha. So it's no. all about just listening, to be honest. Okay. It's all about listening. It's not anything hard. You just have to listen and learn and be patient with it because it's not going to be easy. But if you have patience, you'll get it.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Absolutely.
Where will we see you, Kijanae? Well, just a few years from now, what can we expect? Are we going to see another BET Sunday Best
yeah,
Race
yeah.
to the Stage
Hopefully.
Award
I want to do that. I do want to go on Sunday's Best. I just want to be a face for the young people, like I said. I want to be a face for the young people, and I just want to do positive things. So you will be seeing me.
I know that's right. Well, we're going to see you here at Pensacola yeah. State because you're coming
yes,
and you're going to be majoring in music.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. That'll be inspirational for some of our musical students already here because they're going to hear how you sing. And those who want to come, they're going to know how to do what you do and get here.
Yes.
And then, Dwayne, same thing goes out to you. Where will we see you in just a few years? What are your aspirations?
Well, currently I'm in the process of launching my own record label, independent record label. I'm gonna start from home right here in Pensacola. So everyone should expect to hear some great music. We're actually releasing my single February 3rd next year, and I'll be airing on Joyful Noise again on BET again in February or March. I'm sorry, as well. So everybody just tune in and just stay updated. You know, my website www.DwayneCrockerJr.net, so you can get all the updates that we have. Yes, ma'am.
All right. Well, you know, the wonderful thing is that you're both from Pensacola, son and daughter of Pensacola, and we're so proud of you. You ladies and gents, we just expect great things from you all, and we wish you the best. We're going to get a chance to listen to you now, and we appreciate having you here. And while you do what you do, I'm going to be doing what I do best. I'm not going to be singing, but I'll be enjoying this wonderful treat from Chef Kamathi. So thank you, guys. We'll be
thank
listening.
You.
Thank you.
All right.
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Silent night. Oh, hear the angels' voice.
And you were listening to the soulful Christmas sounds from the lovely and talented Kijanae Chester. And of course, just before her and with her, we also had Dwayne Crocker. These are two very young folks who just have some outstanding talents. And I want to bring them back here and talk to them a little bit more here on The Ware Show as we're celebrating the holidays. And we thank you all once again for being here. Absolutely outstanding. I couldn't pay you for what you just did. And then you've never sang together, yet you sang beautifully today on The Ware Show. So thanks again. Also, I want to say this, that Dwayne, you're under the weather and you sound like that. That's awesomeness. So now tell me, that just makes you think to yourself, how much practice goes into what you do to sound like you do? And either of you can take that question. I want both of you to answer it.
Well, I would say I practice every single day. I've been practicing every single day for years. So, you know, it's really a habit. You know, when your practice becomes a habit, that's when you know you're doing it right, when you wake up wanting to sing, hitting the note everywhere you go, walking down the grocery aisle, you know, just practicing singing, you know.
And what about you, Keishan?
The same thing. You have to practice. It doesn't matter if it's just a little cold, you still push on. Just like him, you see how he sounds. He sounds amazing.
Amazing.
With the cold. With the cold. It's just like he said, you just need to practice, get up and sing and do what you feel. Do what you feel. That's what I...
It's almost as if you have a song in your heart. Would you say that? And you just kind of walk around with that kind of song in your heart, because you're talking about just walking down grocery aisles and just around the house, just always having something to sing about.
Yes, ma'am.
That's absolutely a gift. And I'm glad you all are using it and sharing it with us.
Absolutely.
I can't say that enough. I also want to know a little bit about how you all see yourselves set apart from others, because a lot of people have a lot of great talent to sing and that sort of story. And as we say, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. But what is it that you think that can set you apart as you go forward? Because it's going to be pretty competitive out there. But you've got something going, because, Dwayne, you've already won the BET 2015 Sunday Best Race to the Stage Award last year. So tell us, what do you think will make your voice and what makes you different stand out?
Well, for this generation, I guess I can use this term, the hustle. Your
Love
hustle
it.
Will set you apart. What you're willing to go through and what you're willing to bear to reach where you want to reach your goal or your destination. And that's really what sets you apart from everyone else, because there are plenty of singers, there are plenty of musicians, plenty of football players, plenty of news anchors, but you have to look at it like, you know, am I going to work as hard as they are, you know? So that's really what to me is the hustle. So.
And so what do you think?
I just feel like I have the spirit of determination. Like, if I want something, I'm going to go and get it. Ever since I was a kid, when I got in talent shows, I was like, I'm going to get this award. I'm going to get first place. And guess what? I got first place because I took the time out to practice. It all goes back to practice. I just have that spirit of determination, and that'll never stop. When I want something, I'm going to go get it.
You know, and I love that, because you're both kind of saying that competitive, especially you, Kasia. Kijane, you're saying that having that competitive spirit just kind of drives you.
Right, and not cockiness. Being humble.
Mm-hmm. And I certainly picked that up from both of you.
Just knowing yourself, because it's really not even about competition, you know. It's just about being confident in who you are.
Yeah, knowing what you want.
I like that a lot.
That's all it's about.
And in thinking about that, who is your inspiration? Who inspires you? Is there a singer, your parents? I would say
my mom is, and my dad are my huge inspiration. And plus my brother, like, they inspire me so much. I remember 3 hours I had to rehearse this song in the front room because I could not get it for church. And she was like, you're not finna get out of this front room. You're not finna go to sleep until you get this song. And that actually taught me, you are going to get this. You have to stay. You have to practice. You have to be determined that you're going to get it. And they all have just, like, put that into me, installed that into me, to be determined, to be courageous, do what you have to do.
I love that. Family support, that love can drive you to greatness.
Yes.
What about you, Dwayne?
I would have to agree with her and say that my parents are most definitely my biggest inspirations. Or my family, either or, I would accept, because I feel that they've pushed me through the years. When I was growing up, we lived in the church. They are pastors, and we had to live in our church once for about 3 years. And the struggle that we went through there, they still pushed me, you know, to sing every Sunday and every Wednesday night. So I feel like my parents are my biggest inspiration as well.
That's wonderful.
Yes, ma'am.
So if you had to have, like, someone you looked up to, like a person who sings, who would be, in terms of who do you like? Because you mentioned Kirk Franklin and being just glad to meet him and that sort of thing on BET's big event. But who is your big inspiration in singing?
I'd have to say Kirk Franklin.
Okay.
And Leandria Johnson. She won a year of Sunday Best as well. And this may sound crazy, but, you know, I'm a little Justin Bieber fan too, so.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
I would say that I grew up on old music, so I would say Shirley Caesar. Like, I love old gospel music. I just love it. I would say Shirley Caesar, Whitney Houston. I'm a big Whitney fan.
And I love Shirley Caesar too.
So I have an old soul, so I just like all the old music. I'm a fan of some of the new music, but I'm a little bit on the old side.
Mm-hmm. Traditional. She likes the old stuff. I like the
hymnals.
Yeah.
I do too.
Precious Lord.
Yeah. Pass me not, oh gentle Savior.
Yeah.
You can tell that you two are definitely children who came up in the church.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, well, you know what? I guess going forward, we were expecting some really great things out of the two of you and that sort of thing. And I'm just encouraged by what I see here. And I know it's difficult, I guess, for the youngsters and that sort of thing in this day and time, but you guys make it look easy what you do by doing what you love.
And it's definitely not easy. It's not easy. Mm-hmm. And I want everybody to know that as well, because they see, you know, the preachers and the gospel singers. I'm saying on our side, because on the other side, they can do what they please. But on our side, it's definitely not easy holding everything together. We have issues as well, you know, mm-hmm. But it's all about just praying and just staying focused.
Well, that's what you do, and if that's what makes it a
success. And staying humble.
Yes. Yeah. And sometimes that requires a little balance there, as you mentioned, because you got to be confident, but you also want to be humble.
You have you to guys remember there's going to be problems everywhere you go, mm-hmm. but you have to be determined. I'm going to get through this.
All right. Well, thanks so much for joining us with Holiday Entertainment. We'd also like to thank our guest of AWARE and thank you for being there. This year, to keep you in the holiday spirit, AWARE went around the town to showcase you and your neighbors' Christmas lights. And we want to leave you now with that. May your holidays, including your new year, be bright, happy, and prosperous. And from all of us here at AWARE, happy holidays, and we wish you a joyous new year. I'm Dee Dee Sharp saying until next time, stay informed and aware.